Ranger Marinell, and I would like to welcome you to Glacier Bay National Park and Preserve. We are floating just off of Boulder Island in the middle part of the bay. You can see a kelp forest behind me. Today we are going to be talking about an animal that a lot of people see when they visit Glacier Bay, although they didn't return to this area until relatively recently. Sea otters once lived across the North Pacific coast, from Japan to the Baja Peninsula in Mexico. Russian and American fur traders began hunting otters in 1740. By 1900, the fur trade ended because it was no longer profitable to spend resources to try and find the few remaining sea otters. Only about 13 populations remained across the North Pacific. Conservation efforts to reintroduce sea otters to their historic range began in the 1960s. Around 400 sea otters were translocated from existing populations at Amchica Island and Prince William Sound to southeast Alaska. They first began colonizing Glacier Bay in the 1990s. Since then, their numbers have grown, with the current population around 8,000 otters. Sea otters are the smallest marine mammals on the planet, with some fascinating adaptations that make them perfectly suited for this coastal marine environment. Other marine mammals like whales, sea lions, and seals have blubber. Blubber is a thick layer of fat beneath the skin that stores energy and keeps them insulated in cold waters. Sea otters don't have blubber. What they do have is the thickest fur of any animal on the planet, with over 1 million hairs per square inch. Their primary insulator isn't just the fur, it's actually the air that they blow into the fur, keeping their skin warm and dry and allowing them to be more buoyant on the water's surface. Sea otters have a high metabolic cost of thermoregulation. This means that in order to maintain energy and stay warm, they need to eat a lot of food, about 25 to 30% of their body weight every day. Sea otters are a lot bigger than most people realize. They can grow to be 5 feet long, and males can actually weigh up to 100 pounds. So the average 100 pound male sea otter has to consume about 20 pounds of food every day. And the average for a human is about 5.5 pounds a day. They eat invertebrates like urchins, clams, sea stars, crabs, squid, octopus, mussels, and sometimes even fish. They are also the only marine mammal on the planet that is known for using stone tools to consume their prey. They are often found cracking open crabs or other invertebrates with rocks that they lay on their bellies. Imagine having to find, crack open, and consume 20 pounds of crabs, clams, and mussels every day. Visitors often spot sea otters floating on the surface of the water, grooming, foraging for food, or sleeping, which is a pretty busy day for a sea otter. Sea otters are an apex predator, and scientists identify them as a keystone species. A keystone species is an animal that can disproportionately impact the surrounding environment. In other words, a very small population of sea otters can have a very large impact on the ecosystem that they inhabit. Keystone species often define what an ecosystem looks like, and a lot of species of animals really rely on them for their continued survival.
When we consider how much food sea otters must eat to survive, it's easy to see how they can change the ecosystem around them. The best example of sea otters as a keystone species comes from a study in the Aleutian Islands, studying their relationship to kelp forests and sea urchins. Kelp forests are one of the most diverse and productive ecosystems on Earth. They provide critical habitat for a variety of fishes, birds, invertebrates, and other marine mammals. Sea otters and sea urchins are important for the health and stability of kelp forests. Sea urchins graze on kelp and can ravage kelp forests. If their populations get too big, they may graze a kelp forest to death. Sea urchins are a preferred animal of a sea otter's diet. So by keeping the sea urchin population under control, they help allow kelp forests to grow.
While the classic story of sea otters is that of keystone species and kelp forest connections, the story in Glacier Bay is a little more complex. Kelp forests require rocky substrate to take hold, and much of the seafloor here in Glacier Bay is mud, sand, and gravel.
Suitable environments for kelp forests in Glacier Bay are not as common. And so this classic role of sea otters as a keystone species in the soft sediment communities is less well understood.
When sea otters began recolonizing Glacier Bay, scientists recognized an opportunity to study their return to an ecosystem where they had been absent for roughly 100 years. Using a variety of techniques, they gathered data on the population and distribution of sea otters in the park, the number and variety of species found on the seafloor in nearshore communities, and the number, size, and variety of prey species eaten by sea otters. Sea otters are unique in that they bring their food to the surface for consumption. By observing what they eat, scientists are given a window into the underwater world and how it is changing over time. The long-term impacts of sea otters' return to Glacier Bay and Southeast Alaska are still unknown. It's possible that when they eat organisms like urchins and large clams, they restructure the physical environment, making it more complex and creating new habitat for invertebrates and juvenile fish. Shell litter on the seafloor may form a reef, which could support the growth of kelp. Scientists continue to monitor and research the impacts of sea otters on nearshore communities in Glacier Bay. By studying sea otters, we may better understand their importance and role in shaping the environment around them.
Today, Glacier Bay is home to one of the highest density sea otter populations in Alaska. Scientists continue to study their impacts on the Glacier Bay ecosystem, but visitors come to see sea otters as well. Visitors will often laugh as they float past a sea otter that turns its furry face to look back at them. When a sea otter is spotted on the surface of the water, I am reminded of their home and their connection to this ocean ecosystem. In the waters surrounding Boulder Island is a forest of dancing kelp, home to urchins and sea stars, rockfish and herring. Sea lions will swim and play in the kelp fronds that reach up like trees from the seafloor. All we see is the sea otter floating on the surface of the water, and yet so much depends on their presence. The recent arrival of sea otters to Glacier Bay has many impacts, some known and some yet to be revealed. Scientists will continue to come to Glacier Bay to learn about and monitor the population here. And visitors will come hoping to catch a glimpse of sea otters in their natural habitat. By understanding the role of sea otters in Glacier Bay, we can appreciate their survival and return to this complex marine ecosystem.